Many species across the globe are in decline as a result of climate change, and sadly, we expect an increasing number of extinctions as a result. Particularly at risk are ectotherms, or animals such as reptiles and insects that can't regulate their own body temperature. And these animals rely on their external environment for thermal regulation, so just think about an iguana basking in the morning sunshine. This makes them really susceptible to temperature shifts. Ectotherms represent 99% of all species worldwide and are fundamentally important. So you might not have been like me as a child, regularly going out and searching for cool bugs, but have a think about what you're eating today. Our crops are dependent on insects, whether that be as pollinators or perhaps even as pest control. These creatures are already declining at unprecedented rates, and we need to think about how they will respond to further climatic changes. However, we currently lack the information necessary to properly forecast the effects of temperature change on so many different and diverse species. So, what can we do about this? I'm Dr. Anna Vinton, and I'm a biologist at the University of Oxford. And I use a combination of mathematical models, so for example, computer simulations, field data, such as those from expeditions to coral reefs, and laboratory data, like I'll show you today, to try and understand how organisms can adapt to a changing climate. So let's take a look at the behind the scenes in the fly lab. So why flies? Well, in order to make predictions about a wide array of organisms, we can start by examining what's called a model organism. So by studying model organisms in extreme detail, we can gain insight into how more complicated or expensive or rare animals might respond in different conditions. So take a look at this little critter. It might not look like much, but this tiny winged creature has illuminated a surprising amount about the human body, genetics, and disease dynamics. And studies of this animal have even led to 6 Nobel Prizes. So this is called Drosophila melanogaster, and it's a species of fruit fly. And it's one of the most commonly used model ectotherms, and as such has been referred to as the best known organism on this planet. Now, because they're so well studied, we're able to confidently modify their genetics, which means that we have so many tools available to use in ecology and evolution experiments that just aren't available for other species. So here in the lab, we watch fruit flies grow and evolve in these temperature incubators. And we can control these incubators to change temperatures slowly, quickly, or predictably or randomly. We then measure how long these flies in different incubators survive and use microscopes to take pictures and see how their body shapes, such as torso and wing size, might be different in different environments. We can then use these findings to make predictions about how other species might respond to similar conditions. And we do this with the hope of being able to identify conservation priorities and ultimately to protect those who are most vulnerable.